Hello everybody, our lecture today is about the anatomy of the nose and the paranasal sinuses. The nose is formed of two parts, the external nose and the nasal cavity. The external nose consists of bony framework and cartilaginous framework. The bony framework consists of the nasal bone, the frontal process of the maxilla, and the maxillary process of the frontal bone. While the cartilaginous framework is formed of the upper lateral cartilage, lower lateral cartilage, and alar cartilage. The skin over the cartilaginous part is closely adherent and contains multiple sebaceous glands. Nasal cavities. The two nasal cavities are separated from each other by the nasal septum. Openings of the nasal cavity are anterior nasal aperture, which is called the anterior nares, and posterior nasal aperture, which is called quena or posterior nares. The lining of the nasal cavity, first the vestibule or the anterior part, is lined by skin, which is stratified squamous epithelium with hair, which is called vibrissae hair. Olfactory area in its superior part lined with olfactory neuroepithelium. The respiratory area at the rest of the nasal cavity and lined by the respiratory epithelium. The roof of the nasal cavity is formed by the nasal process of the frontal bone, the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone, and the sphenoid bone, as seen in this picture. This is the roof of the nasal cavity. The nasal septum or the medial wall is formed by the septal quadrilateral cartilage anteriorly, the vomer posteriorly, the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid posteriorly, and the nasal crest of the maxilla and the palatine bones inferiorly. The floor separates the nasal cavity from the oral cavity and is formed by the hard pad as seen in this picture. The lateral nasal wall had the following features: three turbinates and three meati. The three turbinates is formed by bony projection, which is called concha, covered by mucous membrane, and three meati. The three turbinates are the inferior turbinate, which is the largest, thick, severed bone. Pharyngeal orifice of the Eustachian tube lies in the nasopharynx 1 cm behind the posterior end of the inferior turbinate. The middle turbinate is smaller and conformed from the ethmoidal bone and attached to the orbital skull base. The superior turbinate is the smallest and is a part of the ethmoidal bone. We have three meati, the inferior meatus, where the nasolacrimal ducts open in the lateral nasal wall, about 3 cm from the anterior nares. The middle meatus, the following sinus is open into it, the frontal sinus, the maxillary sinus, and has the following features: the bulla ethmoidalis, the hiatus semilunaris, and the osteometal complex. Superior meatus, where the posterior ethmoid opens, and what's called the sphenoethmoidal recess, where the sphenoid sinus drains. Arterial blood supply. The arterial blood supply comes from both the external and internal carotid artery. Branches of the external carotid artery that supply the nose. First are the terminal branches of the maxillary artery, which include the sphenopalatine artery and the greater palatine artery. Also, the superior labial branch of the facial artery supplies the nasal cavity. Internal carotid artery branches that supply the nasal cavity are the anterior ethmoidal artery and the posterior ethmoidal artery. Little's area. This area is located in the anterior part of the nasal septum. There is anastomosis of blood vessels called Kesselbach's plexus between branches of the sphenopalatine artery, the greater palatine artery, superior labial artery, and the anterior ethmoidal artery. Venous drainage of the nasal cavity goes through the pterygoid plexus of veins, which drains into the sphenopalatine and greater palatine veins, which drains sphenopalatine and greater palatine veins. Also, ophthalmic veins drain the anterior and posterior ethmoidal veins. Nerve supply. General sensation comes from trigeminal nerve via the maxillary division through the sphenopalatine nerve and the ophthalmic division through the anterior and posterior ethmoidal nerves. Special sensation goes through the olfactory nerve, which is the first cranial nerve, supplied the roof and upper mucosa. autonomic innervation, the parasympathetic via the greater superficial dorsal nerve, the sympathetic via the deep dorsal nerve, both nerves unit to form the vagal nerve in the vagian canal, which goes to the tergopalatine ganglion, then to the lacrimal gland and glands of the nose and palate via the maxillary nerve. Lymphatic drainage of the nasal cavity. Anterior part of the nasal cavity drains into the submandibular roots. The posterior part of the nasal cavity and paranasal sinuses, the nasopharynx, drains to our deep cervical lymph nodes and retropharyngeal lymph nodes. The paranasal sinuses. These are air-filled cavities within the skull wall and lined with respiratory epithelium continuous with the nasal lining. There are four on each side, frontal, maxillary, ethmoid sinuses, anterior and posterior, and sphenoid sinuses as shown in this picture. The maxillary sinus. Maxillary sinus is pyramidal in shape within the body of the maxilla. It has the following relations: anteriorly the cheek and the infraorbital nerve, posteriorly the tergopalatine fossa and infratemporal fossa, superiorly is the orbital floor, inferiorly the hard ballast, alveolus and teeth, and medially the lateral nasal wall. Frontal sinus occupies the frontal bone, absent in 10% of the population. Its ostium opens in the medial part of the sinus floor into the frontal recess. Relations: anteriorly forehead, posteriorly anterior crania fossa, and floor the nose and orbit. Small sinuses. These are 5 to 15 small air cells within the ethmoid bone. A thin plate of bone called lamina papyracea separates them from the orbit. Posterior ethmoid cells are larger and separated from the anterior ethmoid cells by the basal lamina of the middle turbinate. Sphenoid sinus. Sphenoid sinus is situated in the body of the sphenoid bone. It has the following relations: anteriorly the nose, inferiorly the nasopharynx, roof the pituitary gland, and laterally the cavernous sinus with the optic nerve and the parotid artery as shown in this picture. Nasal function. The following are the functions of the nose, including airway, air conditioning, purification of inspired air, olfaction, resonance of voice, tear drainage. First function in the airway, as we know, the nose is the natural respiratory airway. Regarding the air conditioning, the inspired air must reach the lower respiratory system in a suitable temperature and humidity condition. The rich vascular nasal mucosa gives the suitable temperature to air current. The mucus secretion of the nasal mucosa gives it humidity, and the terminal projection increases the surface area which held the above functions. Purification of inspired air by hair in the vestibule, which is caused by greasy hair, immunoglobulin A in the mucus, sneezing reflex, and mucociliary clearance. Olfaction. The odorant molecules dissolved in the olfactory mucosa are transmitted by the olfactory nerve to the olfactory bulb, then to the brain. Human olfactory epithelium covers 1 square centimeter on each side of the nose. Resonance of voice, especially for letters M and N. Tear drainage. Tears from the lacrimal glands are drained through the nasal lacrimal duct to the inferior mucus. Functions of the paranasal sinuses. They increase the surface area for humidification and air conditioning, lightening of the skull width, resonance of voice, and serve as shock absorption for the floor of head trauma. Nasal examination. Nasal examination must include external and internal examination of the nose. External nasal examination starts by inspection of the shape and position of the nose, whether central or twisted, the nasal septum for hump or sudden deformity, and skin inspection for redness, scars, or tumors. Palpation of the nose for tenderness, as in vestibular varicosities, and consistency of nasal masses and cysts. Internal nasal examination is carried out by anterior rhinoscopy using head mirror or headlight or endoscope to examine the patency of the nasal cavity, mucous membrane, nasal discharge, nasal septum, nasal area, the turbinates, and the meatus. As seen in this picture, this is nasal speculum. Posterior rhinoscopy may be successful in adults to see the quina, the nasopharynx, posterior end of turbinates, and the ostium tube. نيزل اندوسكوبي باي فايبر اوبتيك فليكسيبل نيزو فارينجو لارينجوسكوب او ليزو تلسكوب. This is direct vision with excellent illumination for all internal nasal compartments whether anterior or posterior. Oral examination, the heart valve for swelling in relation to the floor of the nose and maxillary sinuses, both nasal discharge and for cleft palate and movement of the soft palate. Crown's illumination, as seen in this picture, smell testing, qualitative and quantitative assessment of smell is available. Digital palpation of the nasopharynx and palate is rarely done nowadays. Investigations. Radiological investigation including brain X-ray, CT, and magnetic resonance imaging. Laboratory tests include blood tests, histopathological examination, and culture and sensitivity. Also, rhinometry, which is an apparatus that measures the airflow inside both nasal cavities by measuring the nasal resistance in relation to the cross-sectional area of the nasal cavities. Thank you very much.